Hello everyone and welcome back to Reykjavik. We are still shaking a lot here and there has not been an eruption yet, but it could come just any moment. I will let you know. This is the seventh part of the Kristylopi KAL since we have prolongated it, so we're done with our sweater, but we are exploring a few more things. So like every week, I will draw a winner for the giveaway, and I will say who it is at the end of this video. And in order to be able to participate, you have to subscribe to the channel, like the videos, of course, and then of course you have to be participating in the knit-along. That is, you need to purchase the Kristylopi pattern on my website or on Ravelry, and I've been linking everything down. But today we're going to take care of our lovely sweater. We've been spending a lot of time on knitting it, so we want to keep it for a long, long time, and I want to wear it. So one question I get like very often is like, how many times should you wash it? Well, I don't wash my lovely sweater. I just wash it once. When it's just all done, like before we were sticking, it's just like more like to relax the fibers, and otherwise I don't think it needs to be washed because of the quality of the Icelandic wool. It's water repellent because of this togue, that's the one that scratches a little bit, but it's because it's water repellent, it means it's also dirt repellent, that is the dirt is not going inside. So when there is slept or something, we just maybe put a little bit of water on it, and eventually a bit of soap, and put it under water to let it go away, or simply just let it dry and then dust it away, because it will stay on top of the wall and not go inside. Yeah, then when it comes to smell and things like that, I think it's usually enough just to put it outside. We usually in Iceland put it outside in the snow, and it's actually a very effective way to wash things. Our great grandmothers and more knew it when they were doing the spring cleaning. When we are putting a duvet cover outside, also it's the UV light, it's killing all the bacteria and viruses. And there are actually some washing machines that are working without any water, which is quite nice. I think there was one from Electrolux in 2007 that I was really interested in, but somehow it didn't got so popular because, I mean, in people's mind, you need to have water and soap to wash things. So it's just a question of mentality, but it's very ecological. It doesn't use water, so I think it's really a future there. So I'm sure you don't believe me when I said Icelandic wool is water repellent, so I'm just going to prove it to you. I hope I convinced you. And of course, if you want to wash your sweater again, you just wash it. Just don't forget it's wool, so you just wash it by hand with some wool product that is adapted to wool. And sometimes I use the washing machine, but in a wool program, but you really have to trust your wool program. It just has to be very mild, so I mean, sometimes I just find it easier to just let it soak. All right, now our sweater is all clean all the time and smells good all the time. So, but it can wear out a little bit. So there are lots of ways to mend sweater. I'm not really going to make tutorials for you today, but I'm linking some really, really nice resources down that you can look at. And I've also made a few tutorials on surgery. So we're just going to go through the sweaters that I have and see what we can do about it. So the most common issues with the sweater is the friction point. So where are they? Elbows. Very often the just the edge of the sleeves, sometimes of the sweater, and then the underarms. I mean, that really the main areas where it will want to slit. And sometimes I find it's just as easier to prevent it by doing things. So here, for example, I have my Gamal Dax sweater, and this sweater it's just fine at the elbow, but then it has a bit of slit here on the sleeves. So this I can fix. This one also has a bit of slit here at the sleeves again, which we can easily fix. And then there's a hole on the left elbow because my daughter Theodora, the one who is modeling this sweater, she's left-handed, she's drawing a lot, and she has very pointy elbow. So it's a sweater she's been using. This one, which I found out I still had, it also has a hole, but it's not, it's from me. So it's on the right side. It has also a hole in the elbow. This one, this is a sweater from Thea, so it's the same, left elbow, there's a hole. And then this one is a very old sweater, so it has a hole also in one of the elbow, but it actually has more issues, and I already mended, or I did something with the second sleeve. So I'm going to try to show you a bit closer and tell you what I'm going to do with those sweater. Oh yeah, and then this one, it also has like some pretty bad at the underarm, like it's almost like completely done. So I have to do something about that so it doesn't wear out and makes a hole. Before I start showing you, I want to show you this sweater. So this is kind of a ancestor, if I may say, of the lopi sweater. So it's made out of lopi, but as you can see, it doesn't have any yoke patterning, but just like some plain one. It's a very nice sweater, which I was given by an amazing woman. She's from the United States, and she visited when she was young with her parents, and they bought like two sweaters, and then she doesn't, I mean, she said I should have it, so she sent it to me, which is so kind. So the idea is of course to write a pattern, and then I'm making one new for her in her size today as an adult. And this particular sweater had a lot of hole, and it's been mended by no one else than the king of mending. I name like Tom of Holland. I don't know if you heard about him, but I'm linking to him. He's amazing. And I just sent it the sweater, and then he put his mark of it. So I'm going to show you what he's been doing on this sweater. I didn't want too much of visible mending, but close enough. So I'm going to show you now, close and continue talking. So I always like to keep my little hands and eventually have an extra button in the same colors or something. It's always good. Just sometimes it's just enough, you know, to make a little thing like that. Just to have, and you can even sew it inside the sweater, for example, at the back. So you can know where the
where the back is. Oops. So could use maybe a bigger needle. This one is so small. All right. So I'm just simply going to go, I'm just going inside because I don't want to make a knot, just inside the stitches here. And then I'm kind of making some sort of a daisy stitch. So I want to, I want to go inside the stitches here. And then I'm making some kind of a loop. I'm coming back here. So I want to, and then it's kind of a bit of crocheting, but crocheting with a needle, but kind of making some kind of daisy stitch, so you're kind of reproducing. So each time I'm going back into the loop, and then I'm going inside, and I go back into the loop, and then I don't know if you can see, then once I'm going back here, then I'm going under that one. And then coming back here. So it's actually kind of reproduces a little bit the stitches. And so we're done with that one. And then I'm just, because it's Icelandic cool, I never met any knots. I'm just going through with it, like when I'm turning an end. And we're done. For that hole, where is the sleeve? Yes, the same sleeve. For that hole here, what I was thinking to do, because it's a rather loose sweater, it's not very close to the body, and I know, yeah. So it's not like there's some friction when the arm is bended. And I think I'm just going to crochet simply a little macaron and just sew it on, so it will be finished. I mean, I could also do the weaving things, or I could do some duplicate stitch, but I think I just want to put a reinforcement like in the old manner. So I have it's not exactly the same color, it's another bath, and it's an old sweater, so it's probably not exactly the same color, but I think it's just fine. So I'll just, you know, just make a little round macaron. And that's it. I will share pictures of the finished one, maybe in my Facebook group. And on the last day when we are showing off everything we've been doing. All right. So here we also have a hole in the sweater. And for that one, I was thinking not doing any duplicate stitch, not reproducing, not weaving or anything, but using needle felting. So for that, I'm going to go in the inside of the sweater. I mean, this works like really well when the holes are not too So this sweater is called Peisu Fata Peisa. It's kind of a modern take on the costume I was wearing. And with like, it's not all black, this one. It's like some nice color. So here I have my hole. And it was knitted using three Kristylopi together. So one black, one gray, and then one brown. So I'm using both some carded Icelandic wool just to do the felting, and then also some Kristylopi in the same color, because I didn't have any carded wool, and Kristylopi is like almost like. So I'm just going to try to somehow blend them together so that we get a bit of similar color. Or something. Don't have too much of it either. Up. that's we're just going to see. So I'm just going to put it like this on top of it, and then I'm using a dry felting needle. Oh, here I have more than a needle. So here I have some. So those are needles that they come with kind of a little, they have kind of little hooks, so that when you go inside it's fine, and then when you go up again the hooks pull the yarn up. So I'm doing from the inside, and that should be like, that should be it. So, and then we just, so it may take a little bit of time. And then there are some materials, so you can use actually more needles together. So just going to, and you have to be careful not to, whoosh, yeah, pinch your fingers. So it's a bit of work. Let's see how it looks like on the outside. Oof, I already put some blood. Incredible. How did I do that? Yeah, so this is what it starts to look like. So I think once it's really needle felted, I think we can go on the other side. I need a bigger, swamp. Note that is, we can also not do it on this side, so that we can control more all the colors. You know, we can, you can just put and so forth. So you get the, you get the idea. And I think it's just going to be looking really nice and not seeing too much. So if you are going to do this with Plutolopi, I would just like separate it. If it's not with the Plutolopi, I would just, you know, you can always separate Lietlopi, because it's like two Plutolopi together. So you see, it's just us. Oops, it's just like, so we just separate it, so it's looser and easier to do it. And then, oh, it's a bit of work, and then you can eventually finish it with a bit of water and rub it a little bit. But I'm finally going to be able to use this sweater again. So happy. All right. Now, here we have my here you have my Gammeldag sweater, and here there was like a problem and a slit. So for that one, I don't really want to do any seeing. So what I'm going to do is just, I'm going to chop the end of the sweater. So I could like put a needle first in the stitches, but I'm not. So I'm just taking the very end, cutting my sweater. I know I'm scaring you. All right, so now we're here, and now I'm just going to just like unravel, so I have a full round. So of course I have lots of little bits and hands. When you cut, it's nice to cut a bit at the same part. So I'm just going to unravel until I get live stitches. And because we've been knitting not from the top down, but from the bottom up, Yeah, the it's a little bit more difficult, I would say, to when you unravel to find all the right, but it's all right. So I'm just unraveling. We're almost there. I'm just making maybe one more round. Yeah, so I have all the stitches. And now, what I'm going to do is just I'm going to put them on a needle. So, for that one, I think it was needle four. So, I'm putting all the stitches on the needle. And then I'm going to re-knit from the top down. And then bind off. And that's it. So again, I have a bit of yarn left, but if you didn't, I mean, you could, consider maybe once I'm going to use that part, but you could consider using one of the contrasting color in the sweater. All right, and now I just have to now I just have to knit it again. So it's like some ribbing. And now I have the so if I have to do this on both sleeves, I will do one at once so I can compare. With the other sleeve, and no, this one I had already mended here, so I have the exact same length. Because I never know if I followed the pattern or if I added one more round, but you got the point. So it's pretty straightforward, and I'm still making my short pearl, of course. Well, that was it for that one. So I'll just finish it. I'll show you on our last day when we do our life. Right, now, what else do we have? So we also have this sweater here, Thea's sweater on. This is called lopi affection sweater. It's inspired by a shawl from Vera Malik, which is a Finnish designer. She had this very popular shawl, and I love it so much. So I asked her if I could use the name. It was called color affection. So I asked him if I could use the name lopi affection, and this the neckline is shaped with short rows, so that's the idea about that. But it has a hole in the elbow. And so for this one, because it's a close sweater, what I would like to do is to actually I'm going to re-knit also, like we did before, except I don't want to, so I'm going to cut here, except I don't want to be re-knitting all this part. So I'm going to cut here and then cut here also, re-knit just this part, and then graft together. And because it's all because it's the sweater from Thea, then I'm going to add some short elbow shaping just to make sure. So just to make sure I know exactly where the elbow shaping is, I'm going. So this is where her elbow comes. So I'm going to take like 10 centimeters in the middle of the elbow, and in the middle. And put a little mark. So once I've cut the sweater, this part here, I will know when I have to put the elbow shaping. I will just measure 9 centimeter, add some elbow shaping, and then continue, and I will know where it is. So for that one, we're going to use the nibble 4.5. And one thing you can do if you want is just to put the stitches on the needle first, making sure to go on the same line. But I mean, I find it a little bit difficult because it's dark, and yeah, and because I'm not afraid of cutting, I'll just cut. So the only thing I'm trying to make is just to make sure to cut a bat in the same stitches. So we're going to do that. I think I'm going straight, also I'm not quite sure, but can I see? Am I straight enough? Yeah, I'm pretty straight. Like this. So I have now a sleeve, and part of a sleeve is like the true amputation. And then I'm doing the same thing here. So taking the hole away. Now we have two parts, so I'm just going to again do the same thing we did for the green sweater. Put the stitches back on the needle, then re-knit this part, which I know is going to be about this. I will just have to measure and make sure. I will do the same thing here, put on another needle, and then graft together in the same manner that we had been grafting the underarms. And for that, I also have a tutorial on my blog, which is called Knitting Surgery 2. And you have the link, and I show it more in details, because now it's really dark, so we can't really see that much. But as you can see, I'm not afraid to cut. And it's also because it's Icelandic wool, you know, it's just not really going anywhere. You have to work for it to unravel it. All right, now comes to my worst sweater. So this one, as you can see, there's a different of colors because it's not the same lot. So I had been re-knitting that part exactly in the manner that I was just showing. I mean, this has been completely discolored with time, and it shows, but not that much. There is a hole on this side, and there's not just the hole. You can see the wool fabric around is like pretty sheer, because and I had already been mending it, duplicate stitches here somehow. So I think I'm just going to not just take the hole, but just cut also and just re-knit this part, and just re-knit until there, so all those stitches that are really very, very sheer are just re-knitted. And Thea, she can't wear that one, so she's not allowed to. It's my sweater. So she won't make any hole. Then this sweater also has other issues on the underarm. So here, as you can see, it's also the fabric is pretty sheer, and it's just going to come a hole like very, very quick. So for that one, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to duplicate stitch. So the duplicate stitch is like the grafting, but you already have the stitches that you can see. So I'm just very quickly going to show it to you. And I like for that to use a needle that is not too no, this is not one. That is not too blunt, but well, yeah, this one is not too pointy. So here we go. And I had already been doing something here, I can see. So I'm probably going to start there. So again, I'm just securing, oops, just securing my yarn by going through. This is a very old sweater, and I don't think I had made the end arm so neat. I think it's been re-knitted a few times. And so I'm going into the hole. I'm going to start here, maybe. I'm just following the stitches, so I'm going into the under the two legs of the stitch on top of it. And then going back where I was, and then going into the next hole, and then going underneath the two legs of the stitch below, going back into the same hole, and coming back into next, and yeah, this is really, there's almost like no fabric left on that one. Into the next hole. I don't know if you can see something, but I think you get the idea. And again, I've been posting a little tutorial that shows it like, oops. That shows it like really very well on I think it's more like some cotton or acrylic yarn, so it's not as fuzzy. And I put like all those technique over there. I think I'm going to continue here, going from here already. All right, so here so I just finished with this row, so now I'm going on the next row. So I mean, if you can see, I'm just going follow the line, those stitches here. So I have one stitch here, one stitch here, one stitch here. So I'm just following them, going underneath. Here in the hole, going inside the hole, underneath, back into the hole, into the next hole, underneath, in the hole, next stitch. What I call the hole is actually the next stitch, and then following the yarn. I find it obviously much easier to go from right to left rather than from left to right. Oh well. So I'm just continuing until I feel like the stitches are full, and then when I'm done, then I'm going into the next row. So, and then I'm going back, so I'm just going to go maybe directly here underneath. Tom is doing this in a much better manner, and you can do it. I also have been linking to a woman that I recently discovered, and I'm going to take a workshop at her place. She's doing amazing mending, like a lot with weaving, but with lots of color. It's like so beautiful. It's like a little piece of heart. You just want to make a hole in your sweater so you can mend it. It's to that point, yeah. So she's called Flora Collingwood Norris. And I've been linking to a website underneath. So I really would like you to go and check her. Then there is also a Japanese woman who is doing some amazing job with the with some visible mending as well. And it was one of you on the it's when I showed his sweater. Someone noticed that there was like big holes and told me like to check her out, and I did, and I just bought her book, and I'm just waiting for it to arrive because it takes time. So because of COVID, you know, it's not just the yarn, everything is taking time.
Well, I hope you enjoy those little hints, and that you will be just taking care of your sweater and mending it. There's lots of resources you can find online that will really go into details, and you can take some workshops, and you can also take lots of workshop online with Tom and with Flora, and I'm sure you will find something that suits you when the holes come. And like I said, you can also prevent the formation of holes. So I do quite a lot of duplicate stitch on the sleeves before it comes. As soon as I see that the yarn is getting a little bit too thin, I will just make a bit of prevention. Well, I think that would be it for today. So it's going to be time to draw our winner this week. And it's again one of my daughter who drew it, and I don't know how, but her name is Donna Xie. Donna Donna and then a C. So she's on YouTube. So if you can contact me, I will let you have your win, which is going to be this time kit for her Lopi affection sweater. So that's this sweater, the Lopi affection. Congratulations! And well, I'll see you next time. Next time we will be talking about buttons. Have a nice weekend. See you.